thank you all for coming tonight. My name is Simon Murray, and I've been looking forward to getting to do this for quite a while now. So before we get going, I kind of wanted to give a little bit of backstory on the recital, on me as a musician, and kind of what to expect from tonight. So for me as an oboist and as a player, I've always found that it's been something of another language that I get to speak. It's something that's therapeutic. Playing music to me is another way to say things that I can't explain with words. And because of that, I've chosen specific pieces tonight that I wanted to play for you all, not only because I love playing them, but because I hope that this recital can be a two-way street in the fact that I get to play these wonderful pieces that I get to be so emotional and expressive with, but then also you, the audience, as the title might say, can explore expression as well. So I hope that through explaining some of these pieces, you can also build your own connections with it and find enjoyment through them as well. So before each piece, I'm going to give kind of maybe a little bit of background about the composer of the piece, but also my own interpretation. But of course, you can make your own decisions with it as you would. So first piece Dr. Smith and I are going to play tonight is titled Legende Pastorale. It's by Benjamin Goddard, and it's the first movement of a larger three-movement work that in English translates to Scotch scenes. So because of this, I like to create some type of imagery when I play this piece. So the first section that you're going to hear is, it sounds very serene, very nostalgic, and very calm. And to me, that feels like, if you can imagine, you know, the Scottish hillside, and you look out, and there's luscious green grass, and maybe you turn, and there's long branches with leaves hanging over, and you look in the distance, the sun's setting, there's a cabin maybe. It's a very serene and beautiful scene, but quickly as we move into the middle of the piece, it becomes quite intense and quite anxious, and Dr. Smith and I are going to accelerando through that section and go a little faster, and it feels a little unsettling. And to me, this is like, okay, you've been in that pasture, and now it's come to night, and you can't see what's in front of you, you can't see what's going on, and maybe you turn and you see a Loch Lake that are in Scotland, and they're very opaque and black, and you can't see what's underneath. And it's just very unsettling. And then as you finish the rest of this piece, it returns to that nostalgic theme, which would, you know, my idea be the sun rising again and getting to see that beautiful hillside once more. So that's kind of my two cents about that. So I hope you enjoy Legende Pastorale. All right, so this next piece that we're gonna play is, honestly, it's one of my favorite pieces in the standard repertoire for solo oboe. It's a sonata for oboe and piano by Francis Poulenc. And what's special about this piece to me is it's broken up into three different movements, so it's gonna total about 12 or so minutes. But what's special about this is the mindset, I think, Francis Poulenc, the composer, and the point of his life that he was in when he composed this piece. So he composed a sonata a year before his death. And as you can imagine, a year before your death, as you're getting older, as bleak as it might sound, being forced to face the reality of your loved ones around you passing and the people you care about most, having to go on living without them, can be a tough pill to swallow. But luckily for Poulenc, he was a very renowned composer, so I feel like you can hear some of this pain in this piece tonight. So looking at the first movement, it's gonna open once again with a kind of nostalgic, warm, nice theme, and it quickly turns into something more agitated and upsetting. And then once again, as we close the first movement, it returns to that nostalgic, kind of warm feeling, but that agitated theme comes back in as well. And I think that has to do with the representing of Poulenc's emotions at this time, that he's remembering these memories of his loved ones, but also having to deal with the pain that they're not there anymore. So it's kind of back and forth with those two emotions. Then as you go into the second movement, it's mostly just agitation and frustration. It's quite staccato, very loud, and so it's Poulenc's emotional frustration during this time. And then the third movement, I feel like you can even hear Poulenc crying when he was writing this music. It's very like deep and emotional and expressive. But then by the end of the third movement, it becomes very bleak, and Dr. Smith and I will play themes that are just very still, and there's not a lot of crescendos, decrescendos. It's just like emotional depletion almost. So a little bit dark, but that's, I think, what makes this piece so great. So you can get your own opinions and thoughts about us, but that's what you can expect. So I hope you enjoy Sonata for Oboe and Piano. Thank you. are the longest and most endearing, so I appreciate the time off there. This next piece I'll be playing is, actually it's a flute piece. So it's the third movement, Fantasia in B minor from Telemann's 12 Flute Fantasies. And what's cool about these pieces, why I chose to put them on the recital tonight, is they're from the Baroque era of music. And what was important about the Baroque era of music was that it was often commonplace for performers to add their own ornamentation or embellishments, which to me, you know, add their own notes and different things, and take their own kind of liberties with the music. And in fact, composers often composed with the intention that the performer would add their own, you know, flair to it and do their own thing to it. So I included it on the recital tonight because I really enjoy being able to play these flute fantasies, specifically the third one, and being able to express myself as a musician. So I thought it would be a good way to show you all kind of who I am and how I like to do things in my performing. So whenever you hear, you know, there are a lot of notes in this, but if you ever hear, you know, a lot of fast ones all at once or a lot of things going on, it's probably me adding my own, you know, thing into it. So yeah, so that's why I put it on tonight. Yeah, I hope you enjoy the Fantasia in B minor.
Thank you.
so this next piece I'm going to play is, once again, unaccompanied, but it's actually been a really important piece to me over the last 2.5 years or so in college. So I started out playing music at Truman State, and this was the first piece that my teacher introduced to me. It is Benjamin Britten's Six Metamorphoses after Ovid. Now, what's special about this piece is there are 60 different movements, and each of the movements are programmatic in nature. So what that means is each movement is trying to depict a certain story or a certain real-life thing. In the case of these pieces, they're meant to represent Greek myths. And so each of the six movements represents a specific Greek myth story. So the sixth movement is titled Arthusa, and the subtitle is Who Flying from the Love of Alpheus, the River God, Was Turned into a Fountain. Basically, the story goes, Alpheus, the river god, was in love with Arthusa, and Arthusa was not feeling the same way. So Alpheus began to like persistently chase after her and bug her and, you know, peeve her off. And so Arthusa actually turned to another deity and asked for help, trying to hide from Alpheus, the river god. And so initially, Arthusa was then turned into a cloud, but Alpheus was persistent and found her again. So she turned to the deity again and said, I really need to get away from Alpheus. And she was then turned into a fountain for a body of water. And so what this piece is trying to represent is the movement of Alpheus trying to find Arthusa. So because he was the river god, he could flow within different types of water. And so when Arthusa was turned into a fountain, he had lost her forever, but he constantly was trying to find her and swim into her waters, try and locate her. So throughout the piece, you're going to hear like large swooping descending lines, and that's supposed to represent like waves crashing into each other of him going through the water trying to find her and crashing around. And then in the middle section, it's a really sad kind of section with a lot of trills, and that once again is trying to represent the kind of sporadic nature of Alpheus trying to run around and find her, but also he's sad because he can't find the woman that he loves. And then we return to like that kind of wave crashing into each other feeling at the end. So that's kind of what you should try and listen for with this, and that's the story behind it. So I hope you enjoy Arthusa.
Thank you.
tonight, I thought was a great way to cap off the recital. So it is the second movement from Carl Nielsen's Two Fantasies for Oboe and Piano. The second movement is titled Humoresque, and what's funny about that is it's funny. Yeah, no, it's supposed to be like the oboe is telling a joke and then laughing at its own joke when you play. So I thought it would be a good way to end the recital that's had some darker kind of pieces. So I thought it would be good, uplifting and fun. So it should be fun to listen to. It's going to be loud, poignant, and yeah, so I hope you enjoy Humoresque.
Thank you.